Welcome back. Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton zeroing in on key voter groups with 3 days until Election Day. New Fox News polls show that Hillary Clinton is leading with female voters by 13 points now as the two candidates double down on their efforts to appeal to women. Back with me now, attorney Christy Kunzig, Democratic strategist Jessica Tarlov, and Trump surrogate Jason Meister, our millennial panel. Good to see you guys. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank
the
you.
Women vote. How's Trump going to get it, Jason?
Women see through all the rhetoric. They have families. They have children. They want to protect our country. They want borders.
Yeah.
They want jobs back. So I think that they're going to see through it, and they're going to come out for Trump.
Well, I think that's a really good point because, Jessica, I mean, you know, you could go around and say, oh, like, women think differently about this and women feel this way, but the truth is we all want the same thing. We want our families to feel safe, and we want to have job opportunities.
Yes, I think that's absolutely correct. I don't think that Hillary Clinton won or is winning the woman vote necessarily because of pandering on that basis. I think Donald Trump has made a series of missteps in the language that he's used, certainly on tape and off tape, in this arena. And also, I mean, we can say that obviously women care about the economy and national security first, the same as the rest of the country. But when you have a presidential candidate going after a woman's right to choose, which is overwhelmingly popular nationally and especially with women, and when you talk about taking away Obamacare, when you attack Planned Parenthood, which remained popular throughout the scandal, those are difficult things to do. And we were talking in the green room about how powerful these Hillary Clinton ads, where she uses Trump's own words,
right,
have
yeah.
been, like the role models ad and him talking about Alicia Machado and, you know,
but,
Megyn Kelly, and that is important. It's important, and
you know,
it's obviously having an
but
effect.
But what's also important is that the Clinton Foundation took millions from Sharia-run law countries that kill women, that kill gays, that oppress the poor. So I think that you have to take that into account in
Do
this
women
election.
Know that? Is that resonating with women? I mean,
well,
that
Trump certainly talks about
true.
It plenty.
But it's true, and he is talking about it, and I think that they realize that.
What do you think, Christy?
Well, I agree with Jason. I think it's really important that Trump keeps bringing that up and talking about it. I also think one of the biggest strengths he has is his daughter Ivanka and having her campaign for him, because she really is someone that resonates with women, and kind of working with him on some of the plans that he wants to put into place, I think benefits him.
I think Melania as well.
She does.
I thought Melania did a great job this week. I think, you know, the irony of the cyberbullying campaign when her husband is arguably our biggest cyberbully in the country right now is interesting. But, you know, she has a lot of soul. I respect her tremendously, Ivanka as well. But when you guys say that this is working, coming out there and saying she took money from Saudi, when as Secretary of State she spoke out, by the way, about all of these regimes, you know, you're saying it's working, but it isn't working if you look at the polls. So yes, she's only up 13 with women overall, but when you look at white college educated women, she's up 27. Mitt Romney won that group by 6. I mean, there's a real education division here going on, because he's winning these white women without a college degree, and obviously he's not winning minority
Can
women.
Women stop Trump from taking this from Hillary?
I don't think so. I think they see through it. And
But the numbers don't bear that out. I'm just curious how you address that.
Well, and also going back to the millennials, 40% think this election's rigged. 7% apparently lie. They lie on the polling. So I don't think this election's as pollable as
you don't
think.
Believe the polls.
This is not a typical election.
A lot of
election.
People don't believe the polls.
I would
you
think
have
it would be more than 7% lying, because I know a lot of people. I heard a caller from Michigan one time saying that half the people he knows there are for Trump. They just won't say anything about it.
They won't
afraid.
Admit it because
so,
they get, you know, they get slammed by friends.
There's, there's two sort of things that are going on. One, there's a ton of Trump, I think, closet Trumpers. I also think that there's millions, this is the Brexit effect, there's millions of voters that are going to vote this election but haven't voted ever before, so they're not likely voters. They're not being polled.
Influential female celebrities have come out in favor of Hillary as well. You got pop star Katy Perry. She's going to be stumping for Clinton today as Clinton launches a new ad featuring the singer's music in key battleground states, including Ohio, Pennsylvania, and Florida. Watch this. Will that approach to winning more female voters in a swing state make a difference with the music like that?
I don't think so.
No,
I don't think
you don't
care. Really swing. I don't think
you guys are
making
no fun at all.
I mean, no this,
you don't like Katy Perry? You don't like Katy?
I like her.
If it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter. That's not going to make me say all of a sudden, oh, I'm going to vote for Hillary now.
Christy wants a border
you
wall.
You have a candidate that has two open FBI investigations, an IRS investigation.
Do you think
She's
that 18-year-olds who think Katy Perry are thinking about that?
But
they're not.
You can't fool you can't fool voters.
No, you can't, but you also can't fool voters about Donald Trump. I mean, this is not, we're acting like this is a saint here on the other side. Yes, the FBI investigation.
He's not under FBI investigation.
No, but he's under every other kind of investigation. There are a lot of women.
A corrupt career politician and a successful businessman. That's this election.
I'm sorry, I think I live in an alternate universe.
And
what you could just say, like, we have a corrupt politician versus a successful businessman. This man has been in an incredible amount of trouble throughout the years in terms of his business, the lawsuits. You have a man who denies that the Central Park Five should be exonerated. You have a man who talks about grabbing women's genitalia. I don't care in private or in public. That's not nice. You want girls talked about like that? Women?
Well, what matters more?
Right.
I mean, what he said or what she did?
She's done. Right.
That's fine, and that's a strong argument, I think, for the Donald Trump base. But now we're talking about the 10 to 12% who are undecided. We're talking about women.
Trump right now.
Listen, the enthusiasm gap has narrowed, certainly.
Huge.
It's not huge. The numbers don't bear this out, Jason.
This is the analysis, right? You go to the polls. You're voting for Hillary. You read the Washington Post. You watch CNN. You watch MSNBC.
Well, you won't read anything negative in the Post.
Exactly.
About Hillary.
You think she's
Washington
winning.
Post.
You think she's winning. You have to pick up your kids or you have a meeting. You don't vote. I think if you're a Trump, you're going to vote for Trump, you're going to vote,
but
no matter what.
But that's his base. Yeah. I'm talking about the people in the middle. I'm talking about the undecideds and the independents who might be right-leaning,
but are
uncomfortable.
Well, don't you think this reopening of the FBI investigation, though, did impact some of those
independents? For a few days, and it looks like it's remounted, for sure.
You think they're coming back after first what is this?
The poll, if we look at the ABC Washington Post tracker poll, which is the one that had her up 12, which I think was crazy. I don't think she was ever up 12.
Yeah.
And then it went down to Trump plus one at one point, and now it's back to Clinton plus four. When you look at the structural advantages that Democrats have right now with the Electoral College and what we've seen in terms of turnout, minority turnout, and female turnout, which matters a tremendous amount.
Well, I've been focused on the Electoral College a lot this whole election, but I can't believe that the Electoral College is where it is right now.
Yeah.
Whereas Hillary is actually dropping.
Should be over 300.
Below the 270.
She's in free fall, and I think that you're going to see, you could potentially see what I call Donald Reagan. You could see a 1980 redux. I'm not predicting.
Now no
you
one. Sound
you
like
think you could see a landslide?
I think it's possible. I'm not saying it's definitely going to happen. I'm saying it's a possibility.
Chris likes it.
That could happen. I think with so many people not feeling comfortable enough
to
say how they feel or that they want to vote for Trump and being really motivated to go, I think his fan base is motivated, whereas, again, hers really isn't. So they're going to go
it's
out there.
It's a movement. It's much bigger than Donald Trump.
Yeah, incredible. Incredible where
voice.
We are. You're right. It is a movement.
And Bernie Sanders, who had a movement as well, is out there talking about how important it is that his movement get behind Hillary Clinton.
But they rigged it against him. That's
the
problem.
We talked about this in the first segment. You can't rig 3.8 million votes. It doesn't happen.
Well, we know it would. I mean, we know that they were all in the tank for Hillary, and
I don't think that Bernie Sanders
they pushed Bernie out. He can't be happy about that.
They said they stuck a knife in his back.
They said a lot of things, and if Trump emailed, I'm sure we'd have plenty to look through.
And by the way, the millennials don't like that rigging.
No.
Yeah, but they don't like your candidate.
They want an honest situation.
Yeah, they don't like lock her up, execute her. I mean, people scream things at rallies.
Well, there's that, too.
Okay.
All right, great panel, you guys. Thank you so much. It's amazing that we are here 3 days away, and we're still having this debate, and it's so close.
Yeah.
Coming up next, the hacking threat and the election. Now the U.S. is reportedly ready to strike back if Russia tries to get in the way of the vote. Plus, one of the biggest hits of the campaign, products using some of the top quotes from the election, including Nasty Woman and Bad Hombre. We're going to check out who's making money on all this back in a minute.